What's up everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and today I want to show you how I use the pen tool in my illustrations. There are two ways to create lines. You can either stroke the line or draw the shape of the line and fill it. I'm going to show you a couple of examples of where I use stroke versus fill, and I'll show you some ways of creating some basic hashing as well. So let's get to it. Okay, starting off here, I've got a few different examples here. Here is a drawing of a rose. I also have in here the water logo that I have done for myself. And we have some scroll art as well. So these are a few different types of lines that I'm going to be working with and showing you the differences between the stroke and fill feature. So starting off, we'll use this one here as an example. I'm going to go ahead and grab the pen tool here. If you look over here, we've got two different options here. This ring represents the stroke itself, while the full circle represents the fill color. So if I just go ahead real quick and create a new layer. So if I start off my stroke here and I click and drag, see how it creates a line? If I continue this line around and connect and finish that shape, I've got my stroke here in black, which you can see here on the screen. And the fill right now has got this red line through it, so that means there is no fill. I can select any one of these colors here, so I'll just go ahead and select this gray, and it now fills that shape that I created. I can always come up here to this small circle with the red line through it to cancel the fill, or if I hit the double arrow here, I could switch the stroke to the fill or vice versa. If I select on the stroke itself, I can hit the red line again and kill the stroke itself. So we'll go ahead and get rid of this for now. And working with just the stroke, I'll show you how we can create some lines. So if I start in here, my first point, and then click and drag. Now to control and pull this handle back, we want to hold the control. We pull the handle back and continue making our way around the object we're working with here. I'm going to hold control again and shrink this handle back to make this curve. I can also hold the space bar to move the entirety of the node if I want to reposition it. And we'll continue our line. Okay. Just about there. Now we get to a section like this where I want to make a sharp turn back down. If I just go ahead and hover over the node, you'll see the minus sign next to the pen itself. I'll just go ahead and click that, and that'll make it it'll turn it from a circular node to a square node, which represents a sharp stop. And then we'll just come back down here. Now once I've finished my stroked line, I will double click on that node to close it. Okay, so now when we take a step back here, I've got my stroke. You can see it's filled here with black. If I go over to the stroke menu over here, it gives me various options. I can make the stroke thicker. I can change the caps from a circular cap to a square cap. I can also change where the stroke itself fills. Right now you can see my node line is right directly in the middle of the stroke. You can have it pushed to the outside or the inside. Another cool thing here with the stroke feature is down here next to properties is the pressure. If you go ahead and press on that, it will bring up this menu here, and you can see how you can move either side and thin it out a little bit. You could do both at the same time, or you can add additional points and manipulate either end from there. So in order to move just one end at a time, you want to click on it once, then click on it again and continue to move the node, and that will change just one side. So you can make one area thinner and then one area thicker. So that's a way to kind of change the thickness of the curve. So better example to show you real quick, if we just move on up here. If I go and just create a nice smooth shape like that. So that is my line. Now we come back over here to the pressure. You can see how I can move that, just this side, and make it thinner almost to a point while still keeping thickness on that side. I can move any other part and continue to taper that curve, okay? So we'll use stuff like this here in a little bit for various hatching effects. We'll go ahead and get rid of that for right now. So this is one way to use the stroke as the line. We've got this nice line here. Next, I'm going to show you how to draw the shape of the line and use the fill function on a more stylized drawing like the rows that have some sharper points. The stroke feature works really well and will allow you to get some nice rounded lines. But if you want lines that are going to be a little sharper, a little more stylized, this is where I tend to like to use it, use the fill function more. So I'm going to come back over here and I'm going to switch my stroke to fill. And then I'm also going to lower the stroke line. I don't want it getting in the way as I'm illustrating these lines. So we're going to go ahead and start with this one here. Now, when you're using the fill feature to create lines, you're basically creating the whole shape of the line. So we're going to start on the outside of the line. I want a sharp point here, so I'm going to go ahead and once again click on this circular node, turning it into a square. I will continue to click and drag around my shape, around the outside of my line. I can hold control and bring this handle back. Once again, we'll make a sharp point here. I want to close this and make it a square point. And now we'll just go and move back in the other direction. Holding control again to shorten the handle. We'll close that node, and now we'll go ahead and connect it here, and that will close off our path. I'll come up here to swatches, and right now I still have the stroke, so I'm going to go ahead and hit the double arrow here and switch the stroke to the fill. If I'm on the right layer here, there we go. So let me just go ahead and show you that one more time. It was simply set on stroke, which we see here, but then when I go ahead and hit the double arrows and switch it to the fill, all right? So now I've filled that line shape in. If I want, I can come in with the node tool, A, and select and move any of these nodes to kind of refine this line a little bit more. Okay, so you get the line looking how you'd like it. So this will allow you for more stylized shapes. So you got those sharper edges there. Let me go ahead and show you what this would look like if I was to simply use the stroke feature on this. All right, so we've got our pen tool out. I'm gonna switch back to the stroke here. And I'll just start outlining this line. Oops, I'm gonna create a sharp node there. All right, I'm going to double click to end that. So now I've got the stroke outlined as black, so I'm going to go up to stroke here and I'm going to thicken the stroke line. All right, I'm gonna come back down to pressure. I'm gonna kind of even some of this stuff out a little bit. Make that just a little bit thicker, but I do want to make this other end here just taper a little bit. Okay, and then that would be our stroke line. We could always make it a little bit thicker if we'd like. But you could see how on the stroke, it's got a fairly rounded corner here versus the fill shape that we created. We were able to get a very sharp points. So for more stylized points there. So this is a style preference. You know, you could certainly do either one, whichever one you feel more comfortable with or whichever one you like the look of more. I typically like this more stylized look, and it's a little more akin to my comic style of work. Now, when we do have a stroked line like this, we will want to come up to Layer and Expand Stroke. That will essentially turn it into a fill shape, which will work out better later on depending on what you're using the file for. That is something to consider. I wanted to show you an example of how I'd approach the scroll art here in particular. In a way, something like this, I would use the stroke feature for, and I'm going to show you kind of how we go about doing that. So, with our pen tool, still on stroke, for something like this, I would just start from, you know, whatever point you may like. Let's go ahead and back this up and lower this stroke a little bit so we can get a better sense of what we're doing. Oh, I'm just going to work in creating this line. So it's all going to come down to preference, but for me, when we come to lines like this that are a little more flowing and whatnot, I like to try to use the stroke feature for. So that way, you know, you just have to worry about line quality as far as the one line goes, as opposed to creating a line on both sides. So we've got this in here. I'm going to come back over to stroke and we're going to bump this up. If I see any wobbliness in the line here, I can come back in and individually move these nodes around to get a cleaner look. So once we have something that we're happy with here, I can come in here now and play with the pressure. So I'm going to lower each end just a little bit, as long as we have the stroke selected. So now I've got a sharper point on both sides, okay? So back to the pen tool, I'm gonna go ahead and continue this curve around. I'm gonna start right here. See if I can get that shape. I'm gonna have to start here. Again, using control to pull back this node handle. That way we can make this nice tight turn here. Okay, and then we can double click to end that stroke. Now you can see how this actually matches up quite well. We could come in here and mess with the pressure as well. So bringing these down, we can thin this middle section out just a little bit, so that way it kind of flows with this line here a little bit more. Okay. Now when working in a mirrored situation like this, I typically will ink one side. I will then take the completed lines, select all of them, holding Alt to duplicate, and then Shift to keep in line. I'll hit my flip horizontal button here and continue to hold shift to line these pieces back up, okay? Now we can zoom in to make sure that our middle connecting point has lined up the way we want it to. Perfect. So you can see how using the stroke for something like this will work out quite well, using a tapered line, thin to thick to thin. And we could get a very nice look here that's consistent, smooth, without having to worry about creating each side of the line and then using the fill function. All right, now to go over a few different ways of creating different hatch marks. So for instance, we've got these hatch marks in here. So we can do it a couple of different ways. We can continue on by using just the stroke. So we would start at the beginning of the line and then pull that shape back, right? We'll close off this end. If we come up to our pressure menu here, we can mess around with these nodes. Thick, and then if I want to make this one a little thinner, and I can also bring this middle node down. Now I'm getting a much more tapered line. Come in here and correct the tail a little bit. Okay, so now we've got in one nice line like this, which we can then, with the move tool, hold Alt and drag for a second one, and third, getting us different hatch lines like that. We would then go in here and manipulate these a little bit just to shorten them and make sure they fit in these lines properly. All right, so that's one way of doing it. We're using the stroke there. We could also come in and just use it as the fill function. So we'll go ahead and got it on fill there, stroke, lower the stroke. Close that off here, and we'll just come back over here to color, and we'll switch the stroke around. Which again, we would then be able to do the same thing with. Duplicate and move, rotate it, duplicate and move. We can rotate it, we can downsize it a little bit. So you could use the fill function as well. Another option we have is coming over here to our various shape tools. If I click on triangle shape, I can make a decent triangle, you know, the width that you would like, and then convert to curves up at the top menu bar here. That will allow us to come in here and use the A tool and to select a section of it to click and drag. So I could then take this line, and I can flip it for that matter, rotate it. And then I could use something like this for my stroke lines as well. Making the necessary adjustments as I go. Ultimately, you'd be able to hide this stuff behind the actual line that the hatch marks are coming out from. So you get more of a look like this. So there's a few different ways that you could go ahead and create hatch marks. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found that helpful. Various ways of using the stroke versus fill to create vector ink lines for your drawings. I'll have more tutorials coming soon. And in the meantime, like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. I appreciate your support in growing the channel, and talk to you soon.